Welcome to How to Yugioh.
Let's explain. Maintain the board. So in this video, I'm going to talk about maintaining the board in Yugioh. So hopefully this video will help you in learning how to maintain a board in Yugioh. With that being said, let's get on with the rest of the video. So, when it comes to maintaining the board, this requires 3 points. 1, layered effects. 2, resource trade. And 3, meta study. First, let's go to the first point. 1, layered effects. What do I mean by layered effects? Well, when it comes to effects in Yu-Gi-Oh, and especially when it comes to maintaining the board, you'll need to layer your effects. Allow me to give an example. So we'll go to the next slide. As you can see here, we have a card. You have the spell card there, World Legacy Heart. You can see there that effect is that target two World Chalice monsters in your graveyard with different names, add them to your hand. If your link monster would be destroyed by battle, you can banish this card from your graveyard instead. You can only activate one World Legacy Heart per turn.
The truth you need to know.
This is an example of a layered effect. So what you do is you would create your combo with your World 7 Legacy deck, and then you would, in part of your combo, building your ideal board, you would place this in the graveyard when activating it. So that would mean your layered protection there would be with battle protection once. And then you have the Orcus Crescendo, as you can see there, and that card is a negate there. But it also has a graveyard effect, as you can see there, that it can add any dark machine. That'll come in a bit later. Then we have World Legacy Sorrow, which is another negate here. And so these are layered effects, as we can see here, whatever, in this video. You can see there with Orcus Crescendo, it's as a negate. And with World Legacy Sorrows, there's another negate there. If we go to the next slide, you can see here with Orcus Crescendo, what we will do is we will possibly send another Orcus Crescendo to the graveyard and activate its effect in the graveyard on your opponent's turn with another layered effect. Meaning if your opponent were to activate a card that would be a World Legacy, World Arc, you could add it to your hand, meaning you could revive your Link monsters if they were to be destroyed by card effects. Just revive them. Or you could be proactive and attack with, and if they're attacking you with a higher monster, you could add World Legacy, World Lance instead, meaning that you could protect your monsters by battle because you could reduce in the battle phase with a battle trap of World Legacy, World Lance. Or, better yet, you could have Nightmare Mermaid linked there, meaning that all the monsters your opponents out of field would lose 1,000 attack. So they wouldn't even be able to attack anyway, as they'd be losing a significant buff from attack points. Okay, so these are the ways we layer our cards or our in Yu-Gi-Oh, especially with our field. We'd have battle immunity with World Legacy, World Heart, as well with Nightmare Mermaid. We'd have negate immunity as well, as we'd have Orcus Crescendo there with World Legacy Sorrow. And World Legacy and Orcus Crescendo would also have another immunity for destruction immunity, as it would give us as well protection if our links would be destroyed. We could activate Orcus Crescendo in graveyard, add ourselves World Legacy Arc, protecting our link monsters since they'd be destroyed, and then you'd use World Legacy World Arc's effect to revive them back, given with the board state, whatever you've got there. And with various other choices. And if they were to attack us with a very high attacking monster, we could use World Legacy World Lance instead, add that instead, and just reduce an opponent's monster's attack by 3,000, meaning we'd definitely be able to kill that monster in battle. And that's about it. Let's go to the second point. Point number two, resource trade. When maintaining the board, what you want to do in Yu-Gi-Oh is you want to create such a state that when your cards get destroyed, that you essentially are trading resources. That destruction means you get another edition of a card.
Hold on, that's pretty smart.
For example, if we go to the next slide, you can see here with Crystal Wing, Crystal Clear Wing Synchro Dragon, and Drolan Lockbird. Let's say you have your Manadium deck, and you pump this out with Crimson Dragon. So Crimson Dragon pumps this out, and obviously Crystal Clear Wing Synchro Dragon's effect is that when it is destroyed, you can add a wind monster from your deck to your hand. That'll be Droll and Lockbird, hence because it is a wind monster. This is an example of a resource trade, and this is what you want to be doing, my fellow students, and this is the secret in maintaining your board. You want to set booby traps to your cards, that if they are destroyed by your opponent, that you're trading resources. The destruction means you're adding another layer of an effect there with the hand trap or whatever thing you're adding, so that the trade of resources that has been conducted here is worth it for you in the end. And it also de-incentivizes your opponent from breaking your board, thus allowing you to maintain the board that you have created. That is what I mean by the resource trade. So remember, whatever board that you are building in Yu-Gi-Oh, make sure to inbuild booby traps into your cards that they will trade, that whether they are destroyed or whether they are negated by your opponent, whatever happens to your monsters, spells, or traps, that they trade resources, that their destruction means you add an additional card from your deck to your hand, whether it be a hand trap or it be a form of interaction, whatever it is, trade resources with your opponent, meaning that you don't really lose any form of advantage on the field. That is what it means to maintain the board. Let's go to the third and final point. Alrighty then. And the third and final point is three, meta study. So this is important. When you are maintaining the board, you have to realize that you need to study the meta. Hence the third point, meta study. Make sure that the board that you've made and the booby traps that you've put into your board that you have built, your ideal board, whatever it is, that it has sufficient effects down there that successfully prevent your opponent from breaking your board. Appropriate meta study is important to create, to maintain the ideal board. And that is how you're going to beat your opponent. If you can maintain your board using these three points, right? With the first point being one, layered effects, two, resource trade, and three, the meta study, then you too, my fellow students, will get one step closer, you guessed it, to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh! Master. And indeed, maintaining the board in Yu-Gi-Oh! Will be extremely easy. Well, let's head to the overall conclusion. So, here comes the conclusion. And what is it I want to say, my fellow students? Well, there's not much really to say when it comes to maintaining a board in Yu-Gi-Oh! It all relies on the first point with layered effects, and on the second point as well with resource trading. Make sure that whatever board that you're maintaining, that you layer those effects. Make sure that your board has some form of battle immunity or destruction immunity or card effect immunity or negate immunity. Whatever immunity you have or you've decided to go for, make sure whatever board that you've made has some kind of immunity. An immunity means that whatever your opponent does to your board, it will be maintained. But most importantly is that with an immunity, you can maintain presence. And if you maintain your presence, then that means you ultimately maintain the board. The second point is a resource trading. Make sure that even if one of your cards gets destroyed by your opponent, that you trade resources with that destruction. The destruction would either add yourself a hand trap, as you saw there with the example, when you make a Manadium board, make sure to make to special summon Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon with Crimson Dragon, for example, so that when Crystal Clearwing Synchro Dragon is destroyed, you can add yourself a Drolan Lockbird, as it can add any wind. Try to have effects like these in your board building, right? That whatever you resource that you're going to lose to your opponent, like, make sure it trades for a resource, right? Trading resources with your opponent is important. And look at what happens to your cards or monsters or whatever it is on the board as not a really bad thing. As the more resources you trade, this will de-incentivize your opponent from destroying your board. And thus means you are able to maintain your board a whole lot longer, which fulfills the purpose of maintaining the board. The third thing is meta study. Make sure that you've studied the meta, whatever the meta is. Whatever meta that it is at the current point in time, make sure you study it. Appropriate study means that you can have answers in your board building, meaning that the likelihood of your board being destroyed will be close to zero. Appropriate meta study means that your board will be safe and thus can be maintained, which fulfills the purpose of maintaining the board. And with that being said, that's all I've got to say in this video. All I can say is tune in next time, my fellow students, as we'll cover more topics similar to this one on this channel. Well, hope to see you soon.
We come to the end of this video. So, as I like to say, you are one step closer to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh! Master. My fate, right, is in your hands.